Chlamydia and gonorrhea. What is the difference? Chlamydia and gonorrhea are sexually transmitted bacterial infections. A person can contract one of these infections if they have unprotected sexual contact with someone who has it. It can be hard to tell the difference between the two, as the symptoms can be similar. Chlamydia and gonorrhea are both extremely common. In 2018, chlamydia had a rate of 539.9 cases per 1 lakh people in the United States, according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention (CDC). Gonorrhea had a rate of 179 cases per 1 lakh people. Symptoms. According to the CDC, some males and most females with gonorrhea may not experience any symptoms at all. The same goes for chlamydia. If a person does experience symptoms, they might not appear for several weeks, as the symptoms can be similar and may overlap. It is important for a doctor to test for the infections before prescribing any treatment. Overlapping symptoms. The overlapping symptoms may differ slightly between females and males. For example, females may experience a burning sensation during urination and abnormal or increased discharge from the vagina. Males may experience a burning sensation during urination, discharge from the penis, painful swelling of the testicles and penis, though this is less common. A person may also experience symptoms in the rectum. Symptoms in the rectum may include pain or soreness, discharge, bleeding. A person can also experience chlamydia and gonorrhea in the throat. Most oral infections of this nature will have no symptoms, but a person may experience a sore throat. Symptoms specific to gonorrhea. If a female has gonorrhea, they may experience vaginal bleeding between periods. For males, both chlamydia and gonorrhea can cause penile discharge. If gonorrhea is the cause, the discharge may be yellow, green, or white. If a person experiences gonorrhea in the rectum, they may experience anal itching and painful bowel movements. What to do? According to the CDC, there are three steps a person should take after receiving a diagnosis of one of these infections. Get treatment. Without treatment, the infection may cause complications. Tell any previous or current sexual partners. They will require testing and may need treatment. This might be an uncomfortable conversation, but it is critical in helping stop the spread and for the health of both partners. A person can talk with a doctor about the best way to handle the conversation, and they might be able to provide strategies or tools that can help. Get retested. After 3 to 4 months, a person should get retested to ensure that the infection is completely gone from their system. Treatment. Because both chlamydia and gonorrhea can present with no symptoms, it is important that people who are sexually active get tested regularly. After the doctor has determined which infection a person has contracted, they will prescribe an antibiotic. People should take the full course of antibiotics and wait an additional 7 days before having sex again. This helps prevent a person from spreading the infection to another person and possibly reinfecting themselves later. A person can contract both chlamydia and gonorrhea again, even if they have already experienced and tested the STI before. Who is at risk and how can they prevent it? Any person who is sexually active has a risk of STIs. A person can transmit or contract STIs through oral, anal, or vaginal sexual intercourse. To prevent contracting either of these infections, a person should use barrier methods such as condoms and get tested regularly. complications. Even when they do not cause any symptoms, these infections can cause complications. If a person does not seek treatment for gonorrhea, for example, there may be a higher chance of contracting HIV. They may also contract disseminated gonococcal infections. In females, without treatment, either infection may cause pelvic inflammatory disease or PID. Pelvic inflammatory disease occurs when either infection migrates into a female's reproductive organs. Symptoms may include lower abdominal pain, unusual discharge from the vagina, bleeding during sexual intercourse, a burning sensation when urinating, bleeding between periods. If a person does not seek treatment for pelvic inflammatory disease early enough, complications may occur, including infertility, scar tissue forming in the fallopian tubes, which may cause tubal blockage, ectopic pregnancies. In males, in some rare cases, chlamydia and gonorrhea can cause a male to become infertile. If the infection reaches and scars the tubes descending from the testicles. In pregnancy, women should inform a doctor if they have chlamydia or gonorrhea while pregnant. They may pass the STI to the newborn during delivery. If a pregnant woman does not receive treatment for gonorrhea, they may experience pregnancy loss, premature birth, low birth weight. Chorioamnionitis, which is an infection of the fetal membranes. It can also cause eye infections in newborns. Untreated chlamydia during pregnancy can cause preterm labor, low birth weight, premature rupture of the amniotic sac before labor begins. Untreated chlamydia can also cause eye and lung infections in newborns. When to see a doctor? A person should see a doctor if they experience any symptoms of chlamydia and gonorrhea. However, as both infections may not show any symptoms, a person should get regular STI checks. The CDC recommends that a person get tested yearly. Also, anyone who tests positive for one STI should get tested for others.